Hi everybody, my name is Josu Etxezarreta. I am a PhD student in the School of Engineering called Tecnon, which is part of the University of Navarra. I am here in order to present you the work we have done called Pauli Channel Online Estimation Protocol for Quantum Tuple Codes, where we will explain the research we have done in this topic. And this is my email, as I am the corresponding author for this paper. I hope you enjoy my presentation and you learn some useful things about the topic. Quantum technologies have shown incredible potential to solve unmanageable problems by classical computers, such as prime number factorization. It is obvious that these devices are not just a theory right now, as we are in a conference regarding these topics, and several of the talks are about this advantage that quantum technologies give us against classical resources. However, quantum information is prone to suffer from errors due to the coherence that qubits suffer from their interaction with their environment. That's why quantum error corrections are necessary tools in order to counterattack this malicious effect caused from the interaction with the environment. Quantum error correction codes have been studied extensively in the previous literature. Most of them, they have been designed and simulated in order to combat the effects of the so-called depolarizing channel. The depolarizing channel is a very useful tool used by quantum information theory community in order to model the coherence. The main property of this channel is that it is a symmetric channel. This means that the probability of the X, Z, or Y types of Pauli errors that can happen will have the same probability distribution. However, most of the state-of-the-art implementations of quantum devices have shown an asymmetricity between these kind of errors, as we will see later. So, asymmetricity must be taken into account when quantum error correction codes are constructed. Asymmetric quantum error correction codes have been previously studied and designed. However, these designs have been done considering that the decoder has access to perfect channel information. What this means is that the decoder will have the exact probability distribution that defines the Pauli channel before starting the estimation of the error that has happened during the quantum information processing. However, in the reality, this will not be the case, as the decoder will have to estimate or do something in order to know the nature of the channel. This problem has already been tackled previously for quantum tuple codes in our work, Depolarizing Channel Mismatch and Estimation for Quantum Tuple Codes, where we tackle this lack of knowledge for the specific case of quantum tuple codes working with the depolarizing channel. We proposed an estimation method, an online estimation method, that is able to overcome the negative impact that a channel mismatch has on quantum error correction. In this work, presented in this conference, we extend such online estimation method for the more general Pauli channel. Right now, we'll start describing the error models that will be affecting our quantum states. So, as said before, the depolarizing channel model and the Pauli channel model will be presented and discussed. And as we will be able to see, the depolarizing channel is included in the Pauli channel model. So, it is a more general one and a more interesting one. So, to begin with, the depolarizing channel is given by the following transformation on quantum state rho. So, first of all, the quantum state rho will be remain the same with probability 1 minus b, and it will suffer from a x, y, or z Pauli matrix transformation with probability p divided by 3. So, this is the depolarizing channel, and we can see that it is symmetric due to the fact that each of the Pauli matrices are applied with the same probability. So, the more general Pauli channel will have a very similar structure, considering the same Pauli transformations. So we'll have the quantum zero with one minus b, and then each of the Pauli matrices will be applied with individual probabilities. So we'll have px, py, and pz. So, and here, the overall depolarizing probability will be the sum of them. So, we can see that the depolarizing channel is the case of the Pauli channel where the probabilities are taken as the same. So, it includes that. So, considering the Pauli channel, will include the more Pauli channel quantity than the depolarizing mode. So, we have seen that the Pauli channel consists of three different probabilities for each of the Pauli matrices that are non-identity. And these probabilities can be calculated through a temporal expression, and they depend on the so-called T1 and T2 times, which are the damping time and the defacing time. So these are measurables in quantum devices, so we can generate the channel according to the properties of each of the quantum device and the material they are constructed. So a very interesting fact is that Py and Px are the same. I mean, with this, I mean that they have the same expression depending on the amplitude damping and defacing times, so they will be the same. And so it is a very used thing to define the parameter alpha, which is the asymmetric coefficient, which will define the difference between the set and the x probabilities, or y. So this way, we will be able to quantify the asymmetry that quantum material shows. So this depends on the time of coherence time of the algorithm we are using. But if we take that t is much smaller than t1, the following approximation will be possible to be made. So this way, we will be able to calculate the asymmetric coefficient of a quantum device as a function of the amplitude damping and defacing times. The following table shows the asymmetry coefficient alpha for some of the most important devices constructed by the main players working right now in the construction of a quantum computer. You can see that such asymmetry parameter has a wide range, varying from 1, being that the depolarizing channel, to 10 to the 6, a strongly asymmetric channel. This picture shows the schematic of the quantum turbo code that will be used in order to assess the quality of the proposed estimation method. The convolutional encoders that form the turbo code are the PTO1R encoders used in previous literature that have rate 1 divided by 3, no entanglement assistance, and memory 3. They are defined by the C transformation called U. Consequently, the turbo code will have rate 1 divided by 9. This expression shows the hashing bound for the asymmetric Pauli channels that have been discussed before as a function of the asymmetry parameter alpha and the combination of all the probabilities of error for each of the Pauli matrices that can be applied to the quantum information. By using such, we can obtain the noise limits of each of the possible asymmetric Pauli channels that will be used to assess the online estimation method presented in this paper. Now I will discuss the online estimation methods. First, I will present the depolarizing estimator that will be proposed for quantum turbo codes in our paper in entropy, and afterwards I will show how such an estimator can be generalized in order to apply it to a Pauli channel. So, first of all, the most important thing for our estimators is the fact that while the quantum turbo decoder is acting, this probability distribution will be calculated. So this is the probability for each of the qubits I in our quantum two-coded stream suffers from an individual Pauli error, which is this P2, in each of the iterations of the two decoder. So this will be information about the physical error that that our encoded qubits suffer from. So if we take a mean of this probability distribution when P2i equals to the identity, we will obtain the contrary of the depolarizing probability. So a possible estimator for each of the iterations of the two decoder will be the next one. That is, we take the mean for the case where this probability distribution will be equal to the identity for each of the qubits. So this will be our estimator of the depolarizing probability. The estimator we proposed in the paper from Entropy showed good performances for the depolarizing channel. So the idea that we present in this article will be the fact that we can use the same information about the physical errors in order to estimate the Pauli channel individual probabilities. So how do we do that? So we know that we were taking the mean about each of the probabilities I. But another thing that we can do for each of the individual errors, so G will be each of the X, Y, or Z possible errors, we can take the mean of the probability distribution when each of the qubit suffer from one of these errors, depending on the syndrome that has been read. So this way we'll have probabilities for X, Y, and Z, depending on what the two decoder is calculating in each of the iteration of the sum product algorithm that is using in order to estimate the most probable error. So this then will be fed back to the decoder, and it will have more and more accurate information about the channel, implying that the estimates will be more and more successful. Here we can see a schematic version of the online estimation method proposed. It can be seen that the information of the physical error that is computed in each iteration of the turbo decoding process is fed back to the channel info box, where the online estimation method proposed will be applied, so that the channel probability distribution estimated, obviously, can be fed back to the inner CISO decoder, and the turbo code can begin with another iteration. Another important thing that arises when these estimation methods are considered is which will be the starting point of the decoding algorithm, because these estimations, as we can see, depend on the iteration. So we must define what will be the first iteration value. So in our paper about the depolarizing channel, we saw that taking the noise limit of the channel will give good results when estimation is done. So following the same reasoning, it seems pretty logical to use the noise limits of our channel in the Pauli channel for each of the individual probabilities in order to calculate the first iteration, so the starting point of the algorithm. However, we have discussed before that we will not know the asymmetry level of the channel in the beginning point. With this, we mean that alpha will be an unknown parameter as the channel. So the estimator should work with that. So consequently, these expressions will not be valid as a starting point for the iterations. So we have seen that using the same probability for each of them as the first starting point, and using the noise limit of the case of the depolarizing channel for each of them will be a valid starting point, as the results we will obtain will be the same, successful as quantum turbo codes that possess the access to perfect channel information. Here we can see the results obtained for the quantum turbo code system presented before using the online estimation method that we proposed for the asymmetric channel. It is important to state that for our quantum turbo codes, the maximum iteration number used in decoding will be 32 in comparison with the previous ones that use perfect information that have a maximum iteration number of 4 for the turbo decoding algorithm. This comes from the fact that when the turbo decoding algorithm runs the online estimation method we are proposing, it needs some iterations before the estimated probabilities for the Pauli channel are accurate enough in order to give correct estimates of the errors that have been made during the channel. So some more iterations are needed before the decoding starts. So as a maximum, in the worst case scenario, our proposed method will be 8 times more complex in iteration numbers than for the perfect information. But as we can see in the results, the performance obtained for in the word error rate will be as good as for the perfect information. So the flexibility that the method gives us in order to operate with channels that are unknown to us, it justifies the worsening of the complexity of the algorithm. Another thing that we did in order to assess the quality of our proposed estimation method is to compare the symmetric online method proposed in our last paper and the asymmetric online proposed in this one. So we ran the symmetric online estimator for different asymmetric channels, and as we can see in this figure, the symmetric online estimator is not able to take into account the asymmetry of the channel. Actually, the performance that it obtains is the one of the depolarizing channel for independently of on the asymmetry applied to the error model. Consequently, there is a huge loss in the performance of the turbo code if the asymmetric online method is not used. As a conclusion of the presented work, we have shown and described an online estimation method in order to take into account the implicit asymmetries that arise in the present quantum device technologies. So previously constructed estimators failed to consider this asymmetry, and this implies a worsening of the performance of the turbo codes, as we have seen in the results section. So our method is able to consider the bias towards the set kind of error and help the decoder in order to obtain more and more accurate estimates of the channel probabilities, so that the estimates that are being obtained are better, and so the probability of error is lower down. And we have seen that this online estimation method comes at a cost of a complexity reasoning, meaning that our estimation method makes the decoding process to need more iterations, due to the fact that first the decoder tries to achieve some good estimate of the channel information, and afterwards it performs the turbo decoding as a normal turbo decoder. So this first stage, where the decoder is trying to get accurate estimates, makes this complexity increase. However, the flexibility that this method gives to quantum error correction codes, specifically turbo codes here, is much more interesting than the fact that the decoder works a little bit slower.